All right, we gotta get this energy in this room up. Woo! We gotta let them know we're ready for them. Let's give them a little proud song, boys.
Shaking that thing. Speaking of such a great performance, I was wondering if you could help Jared and I with a little something.
Oh, okay.
Should I whisper
something?
Can you
tell me
know it
first?
No,
they might not know the song.
Yeah, but they're musicians, they can do anything. We're going to be here anyway, guys, we're going to do something. So, you know, the band could really just, you don't even need to play. You could just
sing
with us your love. Okay. Okay. With your voices.
Okay.
But we're gonna need one prop, Jared. You don't mind?
Yeah.
And I'm gonna need some help from you, help from all you guys out there. As some of you may know, it was Billy's birthday. On Friday. Just pepper with roadhouses. Patrick Swayze.
Sam Bearwood mess things up together. Sam's version of heaven would actually fit because it would be on that same highway in the Impala with his brother driving, doing research on the way to a hunt.
Everyone had a reaction last night on the drive home. Hey, would the girl that I pulled up next to last night in the car and was singing, does she happen to be here? Yeah, she's right over there. Where are you?
Tiny Dancer?
Hi. Okay, so that made my night, by the way. So pull up to her. What's your name? Michaela. Pull up to Michaela, and she's got Tiny Dancer, Elton John, just blaring on her radio.
Windows Woman.
Great song.
Rock the Saturday night.
It's just a stoplight. There's no other cars in sight. Cliff and I pull up right next to her. My window's down. There she is. She doesn't really notice. She's just into her music, waiting for the light to turn. And it was right at when the chorus drops. And Cliff just goes, we should sing. So, Cliff and I in here singing, Hoping all's a Saturday. She turns to look with almost like this kind of disgusted look on her face, like really? What went from really turned to this? She goes, whoa. you had a bigger season other than the one that you met Genevieve?
I like the one where I met my wife.
I read the script and became a massive fan of Deadpool.
Without Genevieve,
on his side, enough of him on my side, it wouldn't be possible. So they really make what we do possible by the things that they do. So, yeah.
Thank you.
a beach.
Did you just call me Water Beach? Yep. Thank you very much.
Two beach, North Carolina!
It's a skunk, you don't care.
Thank you so much. You're
I think the price would be pretty obvious. I would just wait for Misha to open the door.
Got you again.
Monsieur.
Bonsoir, monsieur.
Bonsoir.
Orlando's not a state, it's a state.
State of
mind.
Tallahassee. Darth Vader.
So.
What's next? The next one.
I'm studying mental health counseling at Columbia, and like the internal workings of people are really interesting to me. So what I'm asking is, what are internal struggles that the characters have shown or implied that you wish was shown more or discussed more in depth? For example, like Dean's alcoholism.
Just because he likes to continuously be slightly bent all the time. yeah, that really never got touched on. And I think we've gotten away from that in recent years. But there was certainly a few seasons where it was specifically talked about being over the top and never really, really got dealt with. And I don't know why that was the choice that they wanted to make. But I think there's a lot of, the great thing about being on a show for as long as we've been on is that we've been able to explore these characters a lot. And we've been able to peel a lot of layers off and expose a lot of depth, I think, to these characters. And we've seen them build through a ton. And that, you know, those experiences ultimately reveal a lot of different characteristics. I was talking about this in the meet group this morning. The fact that the Dean has a hard time asking for help, and what, you know, where that really stems from, and why, you know, why he feels like he has to show it all the time instead of, you know, asking his brother for help. He's a really hard time doing that. I'm always interested because I know people like that. I know people that just, they won't admit they're wrong and they won't ask for help. And that's an interesting quality to me. I don't know, that's one.
Yeah, you know, I agree. You said something that we never really got into, Dean's alcoholism or whatever the thing was. And I think what occurred to me just while he was explaining a lot was one of the really neat parts of Supernatural is that we've seen so, unlike any other TV show that I can think of, we've seen so many facets of these characters, of Sam Winchester and Dean Winchester, that they've embodied everything. They've embodied alcoholism, they've embodied sociopathy, they've embodied a lot of bizarre characteristics. But their overarching message is the same. They're trying to help others, they're trying to help each other, they're committed, they're loyal. And so I think wonderfully, as opposed to focusing on Sam was addicted to demon blood, or Dean had an eye opener, or it killed a bunch of people, or whatever, it's focusing more on who they're trying to be every day. So I'm going to go on.
Beautiful!
figure you're supposed to have a beard if you're eating that cake, right?
Yeah, your beard only because you can see.
Right. There's evidence.
Right.
Why are you guys doing out here?
We're just gonna hang out. You can answer the question. What?
Okay. I think we've got a question over here.
Yes.
Hi.
Hi, my name is Cookie.
Give it up to Tim Robinson. That fight scene took an entire day to shoot. It took a whole day, but one of the key elements of that fight scene was that the demon that I killed at the end, sticking to the table with a knife, he was my stunt double. So he's a guy I've been working with for almost 14 years. So I trust him. He trusts me.
14 because of Dark Angel.
Yeah, he was my stunt double. Dark Angel. That we were able to really go at it a few times. The caveat is that he was my stunt double, so I didn't have one. So I had to do everything myself. Everything he was supposed to do, I had to do. There was nobody backing me up. So it was fun, but yes, it takes a long, long time to do it, which is why we don't do them all the time. But when we do them, I really enjoy it. I'd rather do a whole day of it. Fight sequence and a whole day of dialogue any day.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That Balthazar was painting the sigil on to throw us through the window, right? And it was right there, and Sebastian, God's name, he's doing his thing. And Jerry and I are standing right there, like next to the couch, and the bowl starts to slowly tip. And it tips slowly. It's very slowly. And then, and I'm looking, Jerry's standing right there. All he had to do was go like this. That fast. It was. And Sebby just, we both look at him like, is he not going to say, why is he? Is he? And he topples, and he goes like this. Huh? Immediately he turns to me and goes, I always hoped I would react like that. Very peaceful. Very good. All right, thank you.
Charity of birthday boys choosing, so at some point in time today, don't miss a little bit.